has been we will talk about indicators now, and in the lectures that we saw here, we attended here, you could see a lot of indicators, so we will talk a little bit more about that. So, I'm talking what are indicators, why do we need indicators, some functions of indicators, some popular indicators, the ecological issue, is how to create an indicator or index. What are indicators? So, a classical definition is a variable or index. It's useful to summarize a lot of information in a single value. And when we have an indicator, sometimes we need the value of indicator in relation to reference value. It's important. And another definition is an indirect measure for what we cannot measure directly. For example, the sea surface temperature is an indicator of water temperature, or mean size of fish is an indicator of size in community structure. Number of species is an indicator of a health community, but we need to note the reference value in this case. Some examples, many different kinds of indicators, environmental, you can use salinity, chlorophyll, economic, Rashid told us about the GDP, social, number of workers, governance, number of fishermen organization. There are a multitude of indicators in the literature, simple ones, complex, and the type of indicators could be varied. Why do you need indicators? Indicators serve for basic functions: simplification, quantification, standardization, and communication. Simplification because ecosystems, they are so complex systems, and we have a lot of drivers in, for example, food web, anthropogenic drivers, climate, physical drivers, and we have the services in the ecosystem, so you need to simplify, to summarize these things. Quantification, how have things changed? We can use the indicators. Here, in this case, we have the reference value. It's almost, in the majority of times, it's very useful, the reference values. Priscilla showed us exactly this slide. In this case, it's a cumulative human impact into the ocean. So we have here, the dark color is very high impact, and the blue color is a very low impact in the ocean. And for communication and education, indicators provide a clear message for the stakeholder or the public. Cholesterol is an indicator, maybe, of the probability to take a heart attack. So this is an indicator, okay? And it's important to us to know this indicator, to manage ourselves. Some specific function of indicators. Measure the overall state of the ecosystem health in a management area, for example. So I put this example here. River dolphin as indicators of ecosystem degradation. So in this case, the density of river dolphins has a negative correlation with degradation index in many areas, in 90 areas in Amazon forest. So in this case, how the authors did this degradation index? In this case, they created the overall score and the high impact, where majority of human stress were classified as high or medium. Medium and the low impact also. And they put in some notes, some values for this score. So the human stressors are varied. So we have water quality, for example, oil exploitation, depending on size, and the category, the impact categories. If the distance from the study area is 100, 200 kilometers, is a low impact. If it is within in the area, is a high impact. If it is 50 kilometers, a medium impact. So we have a lot of human stressor here. You can create this overall index, degradation index in these areas here. Measure the state of different ecosystem attributes. So the classical Shannon diversity index could be used to analyze the species diversity in a place, or even the Ignis could be used also. Large fish indicator could be attributed to understand the community structure. Man life span is attributed for resilience and so on. Measure impacts, effects, and consequences. In this case, three indicators to tell about overfishing. So, for this author, percentage of mature fishing catch. If 100% as target, percentage of species with optimal length in catch, 100 as target, and percentage of mega spawner in catch, 0% as target. So in this case, in this scenario, we can see a lot of juveniles caught, so this is not respected. We can see a lot of mega spawners in the lands, so it's not a respect. And the catch is not isn't has not the optimal length. So for these three indicators, this scenario of the overfishing scenario. Some popular indicators for us. Rape indicators are very popular. Just to divide some things for the other thing. For example, predatory fish by forage fish. Demersal fish divided by pelagic fish, predatory fish divided by other fish. So for example, this graph, the index predatory divided by forage fish is decreasing. It's decreasing because the forage fish is increasing, not because the predatory fish is decreasing or increasing, but so the indicator show us this situation here. Another classical indicator, they are the trophic level basic indicator. So there are three ideas behind them. Fishing down food web, top predators are becoming scarce and replaced by species of low trophic level. Fishing through catch of top predators are maintained, and the new species of lower trophic level are also catched. And fishing expansion when new areas are aggregated in the landings or deeper areas. In this case, to calculate the trophic level basic indicators, we have three types of sources of data: landing, surveys, and models. If you use landings, you need to be careful, because landings are restricted to exploited community. And this trophic level based in landings depends on other things than the ecosystem. For example, fishes behavior, management strategies, and market forces. If you use surveys to calculate the indicators, you need to remember that sometimes the time series are short, and the space sampled depend on survey design and coverage. So you can't measure that you need in this case. And if you use models, you need to remember that models are a simplification of reality. So you need to remember that the parameterization, assumption, and uncertainty in these models. Here, trophic landings based, trophic level indicator in landings based, trophic level of landing catch. You use all the landings here to calculate the trophic level, or you can calculate the trophic level just of species with trophic level higher than 3.2 or higher than 3 or higher than 4. If you use surveys, you have this problem, the time series sometimes. And you can use the trophic level model based, the indicator trophic level for model based. In this case, you have the trophic level of the whole modeled community. It's common in this case. You need to exclude the zooplankton or some invertebrates and primary producers. Fiber index, fishing balance index, is an index to put together trophic level and catch in the same value, and may show when trophic level is decreasing, even if the catch are increasing. Here, for example, the fiber index is decreasing and the catch is increasing. This decreases because the trophic level is decreasing also. This is the formula. You need a transfer efficiency value, the number most common for this is 10%. You need the catch in the first year, and the trophic level of catch. And this catch in the first year of time series is the baseline. So it is interesting because you have a reference value here. Primary production required is could be used as indicator, but here you talk about the basic idea behind primary production required. So if the ecosystem has energy efficiency transfer of 10%, to produce 10 kilos of a predator is required 100 kilos of a prey, because of the 10%, 1,000 kilos of a zooplankton, because the prey needs to feed, and 10,000 kilos of phytoplankton. So to produce 10 kilos of a predator is required 10,000 kilos of phytoplankton. It's not so simple, because the cycle and the production, the primary production, but the idea, the basic idea is that. So I can we could use the primary production required to calculate the L index. Uh, our index is index of the loss secondary production. I would like to show the formula. To estimation the maximum sustainable cash. So primary production required is here, transfer efficiency is here, trophic level is here, and the autotrophic production is here. So you can estimate this, and if your loss or the loss of secondary production of ecosystem increase, if the L index increase, a probability of sustainable fishing decrease. So this idea was based on analysis of 51 models that the author estimated. So if your L index is, has this value 0.02, the probability of a sustainable fish is 0.8, for example. In this case, the L index is decreasing, so the probability of a sustainable is high. And in this case, the L index is not so, it's not decreasing, and the probability of sustainable is not so high than the other. How to create an index? We need to define our goals, and we need to remember that an indicator means a process or pattern. We need to define reference values, and in this to start, we may use ratios and proportion. It's very interesting to use this. And we need to compare different areas or type series. This is an example very useful in Brazil, Habitat Integrity Index. It was developed by Amazon Strings. So the authors chose 12 characteristics of these Amazon Strings. And for each characteristic, they have they put six conditions. And for example, this characteristic, land use pattern behind the riparian zone. If this land use behind the riparian zone of the stream is a primary continuous forest, the fragment is big, so the score is six. If this riparian zone is a pasture, the score is 3. If there is no forest or pasture, just the soil, so the score is just 1. Humidity of riparian forest, if it is a continuous forest, the score is 6. If the riparian forest is very bad or absent, so the score is 1. So, for the 12 characteristics, it's the same. And the habitat integrity index varies between 0 and 1. In this case, you can use this formula to calculate, and you can change the weight of each eating, just to change this value here. This habitat integrity index could be adapted to other ecosystems, just to change characteristics, including social, economics, you can put it there, and conditions, and different weight for each eating if you need necessary for your paper, your indicator. Scoring values could be decided in experts group discussion, and in this case, the experts might be fishers or scientists or stakeholders, including social scientists, okay, or unsocial scientists also. Human Development Index, Rashid told to us, is originally calculated using life expectancy, education, income per capita. It's a simple formula, just this: actual value minus minimum value divided by maximum value minus minimum value. Just this is the AGI. Actual value, for example, actual value 90% of kids at school, maximum value 100 kids at school, minimum value 85 kids at school. So in this case, the AGI is just 0.3. Minimum value, you need to decide, you need to choose the minimum value and the maximum value also. If the actual value is equal to maximum value, so the AGI is 1. And if the actual is equal to minimum value, the AGI is equal to 0. And the AGI could be negative if the actual value is lower than minimum value. So it's very simple formula, very useful. In this case, it's a map of the AGI in Brazil in 6 years ago. If red is bad, some areas is bad here, yellow is better, and green is good, blue is the most high value. You can see blue here and this in Brasília also. Just remember that this is just an index. If the IG here is high, do not mean that you can move, you need to move to there. You just an index. Consider it life expectancy, education, income per capita. Maybe not a good quality of life. You can use AGI to adaptate in some cases. In this case, we adapted for Amazonian catfish fisher many years ago. And in this case, we included economic, political, and social issues, and biological data. So it's not good here, but in economic, we use variables income from catfish fishing, income from other species exploitation. For political, number of voters in the last election in that community, in that fish community. And the social number of schools in that community. So we did this for five regions in Amazon River, for two, and we used two species, Dourada and Piramutaba. For Tabatinga, in this region, in the borders of Brazil, Peru, and Colombia, the social issue has this value, the biological for Dourada is value, and the economic is so low, this the value of the economic issue. Biological Dourada is high, almost 1, because here they catch the size of Dourada catch is similar to the maximum size of Dourada. In another case, in Estuarine area, for example, this X about the biological data, they catch just the juvenile here, so the value is so low, so smaller than this one. In the other side, we have better political institutional conditions here. The ideal situation, of course, could be a like of that, could be this one, for example. And this is different to show these results if you calculate just a mean. Because if I calculate a mean of this value, almost 1.5, 0.6, I will just have one value, and I will join all these attributes. So in this case, it looks like a good way to show the results for the people, for the stakeholder, for the politicians, for us. Remember, ecosystems are complex systems. Complexity can't be captured with one indicator. Avoid this to do a salad of indicators. Indicators are done to summarize. Avoid redundancy, avoid bias. An indicator, no matter how good, presents only a part of a part of a part of a part of the picture. This website has a lot of indicators here, ecological indicator, abundance, biomass pool, chlorophyll, and another kind of indicator. You can click here and look a summary for this indicator. So it's very useful to help you to choose an indicator for your case. Okay.